morning. Breakfast for one. Anthony?
Is there anywhere either on the terrace or near the window down there?
Oh, absolutely. May I have your room number as well?
It's 60. Forgot.
What is that?
Last name is Farrer. F-A-R-R-E-R. I think it's 6103.
Oh, I didn't take that.
Okay. 6103.
Okay. And this one, correct?
Yes. May I leave this up here?
Oh, yeah, of course. You can just go ahead and leave it.
So far, so good.
Oh, just watch your step on the window.
Thank you.
Today?
A lot of work, a lot of travel.
I bet.
Headed across the coast to Tampa. Yeah. Perfect. I lost my slip. I lost my car thing. It's, yes. No, I'm leaving. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Happy holidays.
Happy holidays. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Have a good one. Alright guys, what's up? Welcome to day 49 of A Year in My Life, and I am headed to Tampa this afternoon. So, I've already been up, I've had breakfast, I've gotten a couple hours of work done. You know what? There was one thing that I thought of while I was sitting having breakfast this morning, and it's something I think about because I used to work in the service industry. You know, many years ago, I was a waiter and a bartender, and there was a thing that it made me think about is, you know, so like this morning, I came in there, I sat down at a table by myself, I had a $15 breakfast, but I sat there for 2 hours. Now, I like to think that people think like me and they understand that, yes, you're only spending $15, so a 20% tip. And by the way, you should always tip 20% if your waiter is very good and the food's good, because after those guys tip out, you know, tip share to the back end and stuff, they really only take home about 12 to 13%. Then they get taxed on top of that. So tip 20%. But I want to say that most people probably look at that $15 bill and they tip 20% on that $15, which is $3, even though they took up that table for 2 hours like I did. Now, something that I have always been big on doing is if I'm going to take up somebody's table, be aware that they're in the business to turn tables. You know, that 2 hours I was sitting there in a hotel for breakfast, he could have probably turned that table at least 3 times, made a little bit more money. You also know that they're trying to turn the tables because even after I'm done, even after I've said I don't want any more food, people will come to the table every 5-10 minutes to check on me to make sure I'm doing okay. That's a sign of like they want you to move on so they can turn that table and make more money. So I tip $50. You know, that's makes his day. It makes up for the tables he wasn't gonna get And then I also slide a business card in there. So whether that anything happens of that or not, I've made the guy money for his, or I've made up for his time. I've shown him that I was aware that I was taking up his table. I wasn't just being some asshole and then tipping on the bill. So, yeah, it made me think about that. Guys, if you sit at someone's table and you take an absorbent amount of time, don't tip them on the bill. Tip them on the amount of time you took away from them. It'll make their day. It'll make you feel good. It'll make them happy. And then put your business card in there. You never know. Maybe that guy calls me. Maybe not. Maybe he just remembers me. Maybe he's ecstatic enough about the fact that he just got a $50 tip on a $15 tab, and they probably had a different perception of me sitting there taking up that table. It just changed it from that tip, and maybe he'll tell someone about it and he'll show them my business card. You never know. So that's my tip for today. I'm going to go in here and meet one of my dealers and look at some inventory real quick before I head to the airport to get back to Dallas. Get back to Tampa.
Morning. So, thank you. All right, so coming to see my buddy Tom at the Watch Standard. What's up, buddy?
Hey, what's going on,
buddy? All right.
Nice seeing you.
Appreciate the room last night, dude. Way over the top, but nice.
We'll come that way.
Dude, wow. Look at this view, guys. So this is the crew. This is everybody.
That's Monica, Marcy.
Hey, Monica.
That's my designer.
Marcy.
My beautiful white Jasmine.
Beautiful white Jasmine.
Yeah, we nice got a studio you. In the back. Adrian, our photographer. And David, our marketing director, but I think he's actually inside.
See, this is... So I've already been here, guys. It's a little disclaimer, but I saw this. This is cool. I love all that. This guy does photography like that. Oh, and if anyone's watching this and you are as good as Adrian and you're in the LA area, hit me up. I need one. Oh, can't show that yet.
Oh,
nope.
Not yet.
Nope. Nope. Keep it a secret.
Okay, secret.
Yeah,
right.
Keep that part
top
a secret.
Secret.
Top secret. We'll hey, puppy. Yeah, there's something secret right there we can't show you guys, but I'll give you a little teaser.
Boop.
There we go. I want to see the view from your office in the daytime.
Yeah, man. That definitely is a lot more therapeutic. Then going downtown LA.
Man, I looked at this office. Look at this view.
Happy win, twice the view.
Look at this. Poor guy right here has to sit and look at those terrible mountains all day long.
I know, gotta stare at this beautiful scenery all day, man. Just me and this 360 degree view.
Right? That's awesome. Hey, let's look at some watches.
Let's do it.
Before I head to the airport.
Absolutely.
I love this watch right there.
About to put that in your group. So they find five for it.
Yeah?
Yep.
What are you offering it at?
I'm gonna put in a group for 125.
Alright. I got a jet. It. I gotta get over to the airport. I'm headed to Tampa today. Yeah, I know, man. Shitty because they don't have a direct flight. I have to go through I can't remember. There's one going through Dallas, and there's another going through some other spot. I can't remember.
Jesus, but Jesus everywhere.
Whatever. Hopefully, as long as the Wi-Fi works, I'll be happy. All right, bro.
All right, buddy.
See you later.
Hey, dude. I really need you in Miami. You're going to be in Tampa today, right, or tomorrow?
Today. But I'm there for the... I fly in today. I'm headed to the airport right now. And then I've got a fight tomorrow night. What's in Miami?
Okay, so there's two watches, obviously. The Skelly, we need that back. That's ready to be picked up. And then there's an RM35 Baby Nadal.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Okay, that should be sold.
And it's in Miami?
It's in Miami, yeah.
Who's the buyer?
It's just part of that package.
Oh, okay, okay. But he's in Cali. Yeah. So then I gotta get it to Cali.
Right. Well, you have to be in California Wednesday next week. We need all these watches gathered up for this sale.
Okay. So, okay, let me map it out.
It's like a million in watches, guys.
Dude, I gotta go to New York on Tuesday. Jesus. Why? To deliver the RM I sold, that Alfred sold, the Black Bubba.
Oh, man.
And it's at Roman's store, so I gotta go. That guy shipped it to Roman, so I've gotta get to Philly, pick the watch up, and then drive it up to New York. Okay, so let me map this out. Okay, I'm going to Tampa today. I mean, dude,
if I have to, I'll go to California Wednesday. I mean, we need to get this done. It's like crucial.
Let me think. Miami, I can go to Miami Sunday. I can change my flight from Tampa to go back home. I can go to Miami instead. I can come back on Monday with all this, like Monday evening with everything. Tuesday morning, I can hop over to Philly, pick up the RM, drive it up to New York, come back Tuesday night, and then head to Miami Wednesday. I mean, head to LA Wednesday. What time on Wednesday do we need to be at his store?
What time Wednesday?
Yeah.
I don't know exactly what time Wednesday, but I would like to have boots on the ground Wednesday and ready to go. If it's me or you, fine. But if it makes sense for you to go to New York, I go to LA, let's knock it out.
It's up to you. The only reason I need to go to New York is to deliver the RM. But if I fly in early morning to Philly, I can drive that up there and I can be done and back home to Dallas by that evening.
Yeah, it's just, you know, is it also, you know, is it another thing, is it a lot on you to do all that? Does it make sense for you to maybe split the workload a little so that it's not too much?
If you want to go to California, you can go do it. I do not mind.
Well, I think it makes more sense.
That's fine.
I've been more familiar with the deals from the ground up, so I've been orchestrating the whole thing for the last 3 days.
That's fine. Then you go to Cali.
Okay,
and I'll stay home for a day.
I
can do Miami and New York.
Okay, that's what I need the most. Okay, that's the most important is Miami.
Okay,
those two watches. I need those solidified back in Dallas before I leave.
Okay, I'm headed to the airport right now. When I get there and get to where I can sit down, I'll get my flights changed. I'll get you a flight booked for Wednesday.
Hey, that guy sent you a screenshot of says he's very very interested in a solid gold Luther. I don't know if you've
That guy's messaged me a week ago. Why? I mean, the watch is already sold and the prices have gone up. I don't know. I guess he messaged me on Instagram back last week when I posted that watch for like 48 or 48.5 or 2 weeks ago.
Yeah.
I haven't seen it yet, so.
Okay.
Or I didn't see it in time and the watch sold.
All right. Well, then that pretty much sums it up. So.
There's something else. I've got a Patek deal I'm working on. It's going to be another broker deal. It's a 5711 blue.
Okay.
I'm waiting on pictures of the box and papers.
Cross your fingers, this guy's serious, but by Thursday next week, we may have a 5711 Tiffany, the Tiffany blue doll.
Yeah.
Yeah, this dude's getting one. He's got the allocation, and he wants us to potentially move it.
He knows I'm gonna put that on my wrist and go to the gym, right? Just to the internet up.
I guess if you want to cut the bag open, be my guest, so we'll just pay him for it.
I'll keep the bag in it and I'll set it next to my machine.
That's fine. That's totally fine. You can do that.
I just want to be the first one to take the Tiffany to the gym.
Yeah. Jay-Z already beat you to it.
No, he doesn't work out.
He doesn't work out. That might be true.
He's too rich. He doesn't work out.
Yeah, I need to get that rich. Wait, never mind. I don't work out regardless. So,
all right.
Bad choices. Okay.
All right. Let me get to the airport. I've got more notes. I just can't think of them right now. I'll call you back when I get to the airport. So definitely about to miss my flight to Tampa because it took 30 minutes to get to the airport.
getting out of shape. Holy shit, I hate running.
Made it, thank God. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Happy holidays.
You too. Thank you.
Of course.
Thank you.
Lights don't work, really. Have this many knobs, like you have to turn on 40 switches to get the lights on. Let's see what this view looks like. Oh, how great, the parking lot. Pretty cool room overall. Time to go eat. All right, guys. So a little backstory on what's gone on today and why I'm in Charlotte and not Tampa. I was supposed to go back to Dallas yesterday, and instead I ended up going to LA. So I had to change my flight to go from LA to Tampa today. Well, I didn't get back to my hotel room last night until about 1 a.m. And then my flight to Tampa was at 6, meaning I would have slept for 1 hour, had to get up, leave, drive an hour to get to the rental car place, drop off the car, get to LAX, get through security, you know, on a 4.5 hour flight to Charlotte, then lay over and go to Tampa. So I would have arrived in Tampa about 2 p.m. Going on, you know, maybe 4 hours, 5 hours of sleep that was sporadic. So I just decided to change my flight, get an afternoon flight, and get a little bit of sleep. So all was going to plan. rebooked my flight, slept in a little bit, got caught up on some sleep, got up at 7 this morning, had breakfast, knocked out a couple hours of work, went and saw my dealer, got to the airport, got on the plane, things were looking good. And then there was an issue on the plane. Some guy wasn't compliant with wearing his mask, and we taxied all the way out to the runway, and then they had to bring the plane back so this guy can get off. Then we went back out, and by the time we landed, obviously that delayed us like an hour. By the time we landed, my flight from here to Tampa was taken off in 4 minutes. So I'm stuck in North Carolina tonight. So checked into my hotel. I love an adventure anyway, so whatever. Checked into my hotel. I'm gonna spend the night here, go grab some dinner, get up early. Now, here's the annoying part, is that flights to Tampa tomorrow, there are no morning flights to Tampa. Well, tomorrow night, I have a fight that I'm going to with one of my best friends. So I have to be there by like 2. There's no evening flight. So the only thing I could get was I have to fly into Sarasota and then rent a car and drive. So tomorrow morning I'm getting up, 9 a.m. flight, land in Sarasota at 10, rent a car, drive to Tampa. Hopefully there's no more mishaps or anything so I can get there in time to get ready for the fight. So we'll see, I don't know. I'll keep you guys updated. But I'm gonna explore this hotel a little bit. It's pretty cool actually. It's the JW Marriott in Charlotte. So there's like 4 different places to eat. I'm gonna pick one.
Pretty sure they're fully committed for the rest of the evening.
And that's then, the one on the first floor? Yeah.
And then second floor is Caroline's Oyster Bar.
Okay, I'll tell you what. May I sit at the bar? I'll do a couple of these.
Yeah, you got it.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, just help yourself, and then I got JP back there. He'll be able to help you.
All right, thank you. It's kind of cool. So far, this place is pretty f***ing cool. Tad bit chilly, but the vibe is awesome out here.